Okay, so we're hearing about Maharaj Bharat, who had renounced his empire and gone off to the mountains. He went way up to where the Gandaki river flows. And while he was meditating there one day, a deer jumped across the river. It was afraid because it heard the loud roaring of a lion. So he jumped, the deer jumped over the river, but when it jumped over the river, it was pregnant, and a young deer fell out from its womb. So the deer went into a cave nearby and it lay down and it died, left its body. And so Bharat Maharaj, he saw the young deer, which had come out from the womb of the deer within the river. Bharat Maharaj took compassion on it and saved it, brought it to the shore.
Bharat Maharaj 亲眼目睹这只小鹿从它母亲的子宫当中掉到了河水里，他就心生怜悯，马上纵身跃到了河水当中，把这头小鹿捞上来。
And he began to take care of the deer. He would collect grass and he would give it different grasses and fruits. He would give it water. He took care of it like it was his own pet. And because there were wild animals in the forest, Bharat Maharaj was afraid that the wild animals would kill the deer. So wherever he went, he would take the deer with him. It's very common in the world today, many people, they keep pets, like cats and dogs. They take them with them wherever they go.
这种景象在当今世界很司空见惯，就是那些养宠物、猫、宠物狗的人，就无论走到哪里都会带着他们这些宠物。
So because we become attached to these pets, next life we may become an animal ourselves.
因为这些人深深的依恋这些宠物，下一世很可能他们就会投生。
So, this is Bharat Maharaj was, he had been meditating in the forest for a long time, but still with the, when he got this deer, when he began to take care of the deer, he forgot about his meditation.
但正是因为他开始照料这头小鹿，他就忘记了他的冥想。
Sometimes he would take the deer on his shoulders and carry it, just like you'd carry a child.
有时候他会把这头小鹿扛在肩上，就像一个父亲扛着自己的孩子那样。
And sometimes he would lay down to, when he'd lay down to take rest and to sleep, he would have the deer also lay with him and lay on his chest. And they'd feel pleasure in this.
有时候当巴润玛哈日躺下来休息的时候呢，他会让小鹿就躺在他的胸口，他就因此就感到非常的快乐。
Now Bharat Maharaj, before he came to the mountains, he had a home, and he had a wife and children, and he had a kingdom, but he left everything to take up spiritual life.
在 Bharat Maharaj 去山里之前，他有自己的家庭，自己的妻子、孩子、王国，但是他离开了这一切，就为了灵修。
But although he was trying to do spiritual practice, again he had become attached to this deer.
但是虽然他已经开始了灵修，他却开始变得依附于这头小鹿。
There was no point in him giving up his family. He would have been better to stay with his own family.
如果是这样的话，他还不如留在家里，跟家人待在一起。
If we are serious about spiritual life, we have to be very careful not to become attached to anything except Krishna.
一旦开始认真的灵修，我们就要非常的小心，不要依附任何事物，除了 Krishna 之外。
So sometimes we have to do material activities, but we should always do them for Krishna.
有的时候我们不得不从事一些物质的活动，但是我们也应该是为了 Krishna 而从事。
So Bharat Maharaj was there in the mountains. He was alone, but he had this deer stay with him, and he would always think about the deer.
虽然 Bharat Maharaj 他现在一个人在山里，但是因为旁边有了这头鹿跟他在一起，所以他时时刻刻的都想着这头鹿。
When the deer would go away, he would always stand up, and Bharat Maharaj would think, where did it go? Where's it gone? When's it coming back?
这头小鹿走掉的时候呢， Bharat Maharaj 会站起身来，开始想，哦，他去了哪里？他会不会受到伤害？
And he used to pray that the deer would be happy.In every situation, he would give blessings to the deer. May you be happy always.
他也会祈祷这头鹿会快乐，并且祝福，愿你快乐。
So Bharat Maharaj, he could not concentrate on worshipping his deity anymore. He had a deity with him.But he would just think about the deer instead of thinking of the deity.
就这样 ，Maharaj Bharat Maharaj 他也无法专注于他自己的神像，他总是想着这头鹿。虽然他有着自己的神像跟他在一起
，He'd just be thinking, "Where's the deer gone? When is it coming back? I hope it's safe."
总是想，哦，这头鹿去了哪里？哦，它什么时候回来呀？我希望它一切都安全。
So when we do worship, we must be very careful that our mind doesn't wander away from anything else except the object of worship.
当 我们做崇拜的时候，我们要小心，不要让心意四处的乱逛，而是应该让心意完全专注于自己的崇拜对象。
If we just do the activity, but in the heart we're not thinking of the deity, then we won't get any benefit.
如果我们外在的在从事这种活动，但内心没有想着神像，就得不到好处。
So very important to control the mind.
控制心意非常重要。
So Bharat Maharaj would become like a miserly person who had got some wealth but then lost it. And then, when he loses the money, he becomes very unhappy.
Bharat Maharaj 就像一个吝啬鬼，他有了一些钱财，然后又失去了，他就总是想他失去的钱财。
So like that, when the deer would go away, he would be so much in anxiety that, oh, I've lost the deer, I've lost him. So we have to, this is the attachment. We have to become attached to Krishna and Krishna's service.
所以这就是一种依附，我们应该是依附 Krishna， 依附对 Krishna 的服务。
Rupa Goswami gives an example. He said, just like young men and young women are attracted to each other.
Rupa Goswami 就举了一个例子，就好像年轻男女彼此互相吸引。
So we should pray that we can be attracted to Krishna in the same way. Lord Chaitanya was very attached to Krishna. When he saw the ocean, he thought it was the Yamuna and he went running into the ocean.
主 Chaitanya 非常依附 Krishna.他看见大海的时候，以为是羊的河，就跑向了海洋。
But if we get attached to something material, then we will fall into the material illusion.
如果我们依附物质事物，就会堕落到物质的幻象中。
So Bharat Maharaj, he was always thinking about the deer. He would think that I'm like a cunning hunter, because a hunter, he always tries to cheat the animals. And he's very cruel.
Bharat Maharaj 就总是想这头鹿，他会这样想。我就像一个狡猾的猎人，就想欺骗那些动物。
Bharat Maharaj thought the deer put its trust in me, it trusted me, thinking I was a good man. I have cheated him, cheated the deer.
他就想，哎，这头小鹿，他这么信任我，可是我却欺骗了他。
Actually, Bharat Maharaj, of course, he was from a great family, but he was very foolish to get attached to this animal.
Bharat Maharaj 虽然诞生一个伟大的家族当中，但他却愚蠢地依附一头动物。
He was thinking the deer is also noble like him. He's thinking the deer is also, must be from a good family like Maharaj Bharat. And Maharaj Bharat felt that the deer left him, had gone away because he'd not taken proper care of it.
Bharat Maharaj 就想，这头鹿之所以离开了他，是因为他没有很好的照料他。
But he thought, I think it's going to, it still it will forgive me, it will come back soon.
他就想，我认为这头鹿会原谅我，不久就会再回到我身边。
So he would pray that the deer would always be safe, because there are many wild animals in the forest, tigers and like that, animals which could easily eat the deer.
就这样，巴拉玛拉总是祈祷，为这头鹿的安全祈祷。他就想，森林当中充满了老虎这样的野兽，随时都可能吃掉这头鹿。
Because the deer just only eats some grass. It's a simple creature, just goes and eats some wild grass. Doesn't need much to eat.
这头鹿儿们总是吃的只是一些青草，它们不需要吃很多的各式各样的食物。
So Bharat Maharaj, he could only think of the animal, which is, you know, it's very foolish. It's not spiritual to think about protecting an animal.
Bharat Maharaj, 他心里就念念不忘这头鹿，这是很愚蠢的。他总是想着该怎么保护头鹿，一个动物。
Yeah, in the mountains.The deer could be eaten by wild animals like wolves or dogs or boars. They all travel around in gangs and groups, and they'll eat the deer if they see the deer.
在山上有狼、狗、野猪，他们都成群结队的。倘若他们看到一头鹿，就会围攻这头鹿，吃掉它。
And there's also tigers, but the tigers, they don't travel in a group, they come alone.
还有老虎，但是老虎不会成群结队的，而是就是一只一只的，他们也会抓住这头鹿。
So Bharat Maharaj was always worried that the deer had been eaten by some of these animals.
所以巴拉玛拉就总是担心鹿会不会被这些野兽所吃掉。
So he used to think in his mind always about the deer.
所以他的心意当中呢，总是想着这头鹿。
He would think that, you know, he's supposed to chant the Gayatri mantra.And worship the sun god, but instead he'd be thinking of the deer.
他本来应该是念诵噶尔曼舍来崇拜太阳神，但是呢，他现在却反而总是想着这头鹿。
Just like in the evening when the sun sets, then it's time to chant the Gayatri mantra, worship the sun god.
就像在傍晚时分日落的时候，应该念诵 Gayatri mantra 来崇拜太阳神。
But Bharat Maharaj, he always was worried that the sun, he thought that better that if the sun does not set, because.The animal has not come home yet.
Bharat Maharaj 就想着，太阳最好还是别落山了，因为这头动物还没有回家。
So he was telling the sun that you cannot set yet. You have to wait until the deer comes home. Then only you can set.
所以他就告诉太阳，你现在还不能落山，你得等到这头动物回到家以后再落山。
And then he would think of the deer, he would think of the deer like a prince. He would think this deer, you know, is because he had been a king before, you see, So he thought the deer is like his son, and he thought it's like a prince. And he would think, when will the prince come home? When will it come back and give us pleasure? Maybe it's my fault because I'm not pious, therefore the deer has not come back. So when people become attached to something, then they can speak to them in these foolish ways. They can make all kinds of dreamlike relationships. So Bharat Maharaj was thinking that the little deer was playing with me, and I was meditating with my closed eyes, and the deer would come and it would nudge me with its horns. So Maharaj Bharat was supposed to be meditating, but actually he was only thinking of the deer. So he would sit down and he would try to meditate, but the deer would come and the deer would play with him, want to play with him and want to nudge him with his head and with his horns. And Maharaj Bharat is supposed to be meditating, so he's not hearing the mantra, he's not chanting the mantra, he's only thinking of the deer. So Maharaj Bharat is pretending to meditate, but actually he's just thinking of the deer. So even Maharaj Bharat would try to do things like, you know, yajna or fire sacrifice, and he would collect the ingredients. But the deer would come, the deer would get some of the things and put them in his mouth and pollute things. So Bharat Maharaj would come, he'd push the deer away. But when the deer would go away, then Bharat Maharaj would be worried that maybe he won't come back. Or sometimes it would just, after he got pushed away, the deer would just sit down and behave like a young child who gets told to stop and just sit down and stop playing. So Bharat Maharaj did not understand how all this was taking away his attention from his spiritual advancement.
Bharat Maharaj, 都把他的注意力从灵性的进步上拿开了。
So, Bharat Maharaj, he would sometimes see the footprints of the deer in the ground, and he would talk about them. He would praise them. That oh, so nice.
Bharat Maharaj, 有时候看见小鹿在地上留下的足迹，他就会开始赞美这些足迹，就说：“哦，这多美好啊！”
That he would say, "This earth planet is so fortunate to be marked with the footprints of the deer."
这个地球是多么幸运呢？被这头鹿的这个鹿的蹄印所装饰着。
Bharat Maharaj would say, "My penance and my austerity are useless." But the earth planet is so fortunate because she's got the hoof prints, the footprints of the deer on her.
我的苦行呢，没有什么价值，但是这头鹿的蹄印呢，就印在这个地球上，是多么的幸运呢！
So this, by these footprints on the earth planet, this land has become a very nice place. This earth planet has become a very good place for brahmanas.
正是因为这头鹿留在地上的这些蹄印，这个地球就变得是非常的美好，适合 brahmana 们。
The brahmanas can take advantage now to go to heaven and to get liberation and to do sacrifice to please the demigods.
这些 Brahmana 们就可以利用这些这些足印踏过的土地，可以去天堂，或者是去崇拜半神人。
Just like sometimes people they fall in love with each other. And when they fall in love with each other, then they act and they talk in very strange ways and they do things a very strange way.
就好像一个人当在情网中陷得过深的时候，就会说出一些奇怪的话语，做出奇怪的行为。
Just like there's a story about one man who his wife delivered a son, but the son was born blind from birth.
据说呢，有一个男子，他的妻子生下了一个孩子，但是孩子天生就是瞎子。
But the father was so pleased to have a son, he gave the son the name Padmalochan, meaning one who has lotus eyes.
但是因为出于对自己孩子的热爱，这个男子给他自己的儿子起名为 Padma Lochan， 意思是长着莲花眼的人。
But the boy's eyes are—he's blind. He can't see anything. So how his eyes are useless.
但他的儿子呢是瞎子，根本他的眼睛没有用，因为什么也看不见。
So this is like Bharat Maharaj's love for the deer. He's like that. He's become crazy.
Bharat Maharaj 对这头鹿的爱就好像这个男子一样，就像疯子一样。
So he would speak all kinds of strange things to the deer about the different marks on the deer's body.
他会就是他的说话呢，就像疯子一样。这他谈论这头鹿身上的这个斑点。
And he would say that on the moon, the marks on the moon appear to be like a deer.
他说，这个月亮上面的斑点就好像一头鹿。
So he thought maybe the moon will also be. Guru Mai. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Guru Mani?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, okay, we can start again. Okay, good. Okay. So Bharat Maharaj was saying all kinds of crazy things to the deer. He thought maybe it will come home soon. Because he knows there's many dangers in the forest, in the mountains, so many wild animals. So when Bharat Maharaj saw the light of the moon, then he began to speak more crazy things. Guru Mani? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Okay, so we're telling about Bharat Maharaj and his behavior. He was thinking of the deer to be like his son, who is very obedient and does whatever he says. And he said, because I'm missing the deer, the deer was like my son. It makes me think about my own son. I'm feeling the pain of separation, like in the forest fire, the heat of the forest fire. So I'm feeling also the heat of separation, the pain of separation. This way, Bharat Maharaj was just talking about how much he loved the deer and how he was feeling sorry that the deer had gone. So this kind of attachment is very, very dangerous, you see. You get attached to something material, so it makes our life very inauspicious. Material attachment, not good for the soul. You know, in his past, Bharat Maharaj had done a lot of austerity, and he'd done a lot of worship of the Supreme Lord, and he'd done many sacrifices.
以前, Bharat Maharaj 做了大量的苦行, 崇拜至尊主, 做了大量的祭祀。
But still he fell down. He became attached to this deer and he fell down.
但依然因为依附这头鹿, 他堕落了。
So how could he have become attracted to the deer after he gave up so many material wealth, so much wealth and material attachment, he gave it all up, but still again he became attached to the deer. And how could he get so much attachment, so much affection, show so much love and affection for the deer?
怎么可能呢,对这头鹿有这么多的爱和情感呢?
It must have been due to his past karma.
这一定是由于他过往的karma导致的。
So because he got so attached to the deer, he fell down from his spiritual activities.
因为他过于依恋一头鹿，所以他就从他的灵修之途上堕落了。
So, at the time of death, Bharat Maharaj had to think of a deer, and because he thought of the deer, the time of death, he became a deer.
在死亡之际 ，Bharat Maharaj 因为想着这头鹿，所以下一世。
So we should understand how is it a devotee could be affected by the past deeds.
我们从这件事就可以理解明白一个奉献者是如何受到他过往行为的影响。
Because if somebody does devotional service, then all of the past deeds, they're all removed, they're all destroyed. All the bad karma is all destroyed. So Bharat Maharaj could not be punished for his past, whatever he did wrong in past life, he could not be punished for it because he'd already done devotional service.
在过往曾经从事过什么样的错误行为，他都不能被受到惩罚，因为他已经开始从事奉献服务了。
But he made the mistake. He neglected his spiritual advancement.
但是他犯了一个错误，他忽视了他的灵性进步。
And instead, he became attached to the deer.
他转而却依附于一头鹿。
So, to make up for this mistake, he was given the body of a deer.
所以为了抵消他这个错误。他就被赐予了一头鹿的躯体。
So it was like a punishment for him, to correct him for that mistake.
对他来说是一种惩罚，就是为了纠正他的这个错误。
And by putting him in the body of a deer, it increased his desire to be more, it made him more careful in his devotional service.
所以把他置于一头鹿的躯体当中，就增加了他的这种欲望，更加小心的从事奉爱服务。
So when he got the body of an animal in his next life, he was much more careful in the future.
所以下一世，将他放置一个动物的躯体当中。就让他为自己的未来要更加的小心。
Because he was given the, when he was in the body of the animal, he was able to remember his past life.
虽然他有了一头动物的躯体，但他并未忘记他前世。
So while he was in the animal body, he was very eager to come back and do devotional service.
当他处在动物的躯体当中，他非常渴望回来从事奉爱服务。
But he cannot do devotional service in an animal body.
但他却无法在一个动物的躯体当中从事奉献服务。
So in his next life, he took birth in a Brahmana body.
因此，在下一世，他投生于一个婆罗门的躯体当中。
So Prabhupada told us, he said, just like sometimes some of the Goswamis in Vrindavan, he said they have done some sinful things. So if they do some sinful thing, next life they may be born as a dog or a monkey or some animal like that in Vrindavan.
温达文的一些 Goswami， 因为他们从事了罪恶活动，所以将被投身为将被投掷于狗或者是猴子的身体当中，投身为温达文的狗或者猴子。
And after they give up these animal bodies, then they go back to the spiritual world.
当他们放弃了这个动物的躯体当后，就能回归灵性，回到灵性世界了。
So they just get punished for a little while, but it's not due to their karma.
所以他们会在一段时间之内受到惩罚，但这种惩罚并不是由于他们的 karma。
It's a special way of bringing them to pure devotional service.
这是把他们带到纯粹的奉献服务的特殊方法。
So, Maharaj Bharat, at the time of his death, he saw the deer was sitting by his side, just like his son.
Bharat Maharaj 在死亡之际看到这头小鹿就像儿子一样坐在他的身旁。
It was just like the son. When the father dies, the son laments for the father. So the same way the deer was lamenting for Bharat Maharaj.
就像父亲死亡之际，儿子坐在父亲身边，为父亲悲叹一样。Bharat Maharaj 看到这条小鹿像儿亲生子一样坐在他身边，为他的死而悲伤。
So, next life he got the body of a deer.
因此，下一世他就得到了一头鹿的躯体。
But he got one advantage, one good thing.
但他得到了一个好的优势，一个好事，一个好的地方。
The good thing was that he could remember. Haribol? Haribol?
Haribol, Maharaj.
Okay, Ja, you're back.Wonderful. Okay, so that's the difference between Bharat Maharaj and... Can you hear me?
Yes.
So Bharat Maharaj, he could remember his past life. Other people, they may get the animal body, but they don't remember their past life. They're just put into the animal body, and they don't remember.
区别就是Bharat Maharaj 虽然被置于动物的躯体当中，但是却能回忆起前世，而其他的，投生于动物的灵魂却不记得他们的前世。
So sometimes even a devotee may be punished like this for a short time.
有的时候，奉献者。只是在短暂的一个时间段内受到这样的惩罚。
Just before they go back to Godhead.
就在他们回归神手之前。
So Bharat Maharaj, when he was put into the body of a deer, he could remember what happened. He knew about the cause of his death. So he was very sorry. He felt very bad, very guilty.
Bharat Maharaj 他就能记起自己的死亡的原因， 他为此感到非常的难过、内疚，感觉非常糟糕。
So this is the mercy of Krishna, that even in the animal body, he can advance in devotional service.
这就是 Krishna 的仁慈，即便在动物的躯体中，也能在灵性上取得进步。
He remembers his past life and how he suffered, the things he did wrong. So because Bharat Maharaj had made a lot of devotional service and great sacrifices, he could remember these things.
因为巴仁玛拉日从事了大量的服务，做了大量的献祭，因此能够记起这个他的前世。
So when he was in the body of the deer, he would be very careful. He would remember about how he'd been in the human body, and now he's got this animal body.
他就非常的小心，他能记起他前世曾经在人类的躯体当中，可是现在却得到了一个动物的躯体。
Yeah, even though he had come to the mountains and he was doing devotional service so nicely, but he was so foolish that he got attached to a deer.
虽然他离家去了山里从事服务。但是他却愚蠢地依附一头动物。
And now he's got the body of a deer also.
正是因为他愚蠢地依附一头鹿，以至于他自己也获得了一个鹿的躯体。
So this is important for every devotee. If we waste this opportunity, then next life we may suffer like Bharat Maharaj.
对每一个奉献者。这都是一个非常重要的教训。如果我们浪费了机会，下一世就可能像巴拉玛拉那样要受苦。
Yeah, I mean, have to do devotional service, but you can't do much devotional service in the animal body.
因为在动物的躯体当中做不了很多的服务。
So if we waste it.If we waste that opportunity, then it's a great loss. We should lament, we should feel very sorry, very guilty.
如果浪费了机会的话，就是一个重大的损失。我们应当为此而感到悲叹、内疚和难过。
So this helped, but this helped Bharat Maharaj. He became very careful. He became very eager to.Get again another opportunity to take full shelter of the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord.
This helped the Bharat Maharaj. He very much wants to have another opportunity to completely escape Krishna's lotus feet.
So Prabhupada said, devotees should be very careful not to waste even a moment of time. We should always be chanting and remembering Krishna.
要在要旨当中说，奉献者应该非常小心，不要浪费片刻的光阴，而应该用来聆听和唱诵记忆。
We must keep our mind always absorbed, fixed in devotional service, not get attached to silly material things.
应当让自己的心意全然专注于奉献服务。而不要依附于愚蠢的物质事物。
If we do things like talking nonsense or eating all kinds of food stuff, then it will be very bad for our Krishna consciousness.
如果我们就讨论那些无聊的话题，或者是胡吃海塞，对我们灵性进步非常不好。
So we must.We must make proper use of every opportunity, every moment for Krishna's service.
We 应当把每时每刻都用来为 Krishna 做服务。
So although Bharat Maharaj got the body of a deer, he was very careful. He didn't tell anybody about it. And after he took his birth, he left the mother deer and he went away to the mountain. Oh, no, he went back. He went back to the place where he used to live, at near the Kanduki River, where the Shalagrams are.
Bharat Maharaj接受了一头鹿的躯体，但是他就没有向任何人吐露这些事情，而是离开他的出生地和他的鹿妈妈，再次到沙拉古拉姆森林，再次向他以前的灵修地进发。
So we have to do also our duties as a devotee. If we want to go back to Godhead, we have to do service.
我们应当从事自己作为。
Now it's in Geshe-la. Oh, I see. I got it. Okay. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Guru Mani. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Okay, what is name? Rajendra Dawanti Shishama?
The first part of the question is that although in theory we know that it's very dangerous to attach to any person, animal, anything in this world, but in the practical life we have to face all kinds of people, animal, a lot of things. So it's inevitable to have this feeling of attachment. So how to face this world and at the same time without any attachment? This is the first part of the question.
Well, we have to be attached to Krishna. That's the thing. We have to see Krishna in the heart of all living entities, and we have to understand the importance of the human life. Understanding that only in the human form of life can we actually do devotional service. We give great significance to the human beings more than other forms of life.
明白人体生命、人体形式的生命可以做奉献服务，从而我们更加重视人体生命。
This doesn't do any good to show the spirit of oneness or, you know, just to care for the animals and care for the plants and the whales and all these creatures.
Whales, okay. 所以我们不应当就是表现出这种什么都是一视同仁的，也非常关心动物啊，关心植物啊等等的。
Whales, big fish, you know, the big thing, big fish.
鲸鱼 ,OK, 就是保护鲸鱼。所以这样是不好的。
They're all parts and parcels of Krishna.But the human life is special.
虽然它们也是 Krishna 所属部分，但是人体生命是独一无二的。The next part of the question is that, although we associate with devotees and chant Hare Krishna, but we.We are reluctant to give up soybean, juice, vinegar, mushroom, etc. So how can we be like lotus? Although we live in this, the lotus that although it grows from the mud, but it's very transcendental, with, not affected by the mud.
Well, you have to associate with devotees, and you have to get proper prasadam, pure food. You don't want. I don't know what happened, but something happened.
Brother Prem, the dear.
It's okay, let's go on.
Okay. 所以我们应该跟奉献者联谊，然后得到纯粹的食物，我们应当荣耀和杀的。
Then we won't have to, you know, you just have to get nice food cooked.You don't need to use vinegar and soybeans and all this soy flour and all these mushrooms and stuff. You know, you can just use the natural foodstuffs and vegetables which is there. There's many vegetables, there's many grains. You don't need to use all these horrible things.
We can make good food.用像酱油醋这样的调味品，而且我们可以烹饪各种各样自然的食物，比各种蔬菜谷物，而用不着加用这个木耳啊蘑菇啊就这样的可怕的食物东西。
Maybe you use this kind of fungus, these things which grow in the dark, these are not in the mode of goodness.
就是那些生长在黑暗、阴暗的、黑暗的地方的这些是属于愚昧形态的食物。
So you have to come and live in the Krishna conscious community and eat Krishna prasadam. And Krishna prasadam.
应当住在奉献者的社团当中。只吃 Krishna 的 prasadam
We don't eat all these. We don't need to use vinegar and mushrooms and soybean flour.
我们用不着酱油、醋、蘑菇、木耳这样的。
下一个问题。
下一个问题是来自于 Kelly Lalita， 顶拜 Gurudev， 是 Bharat Maharaj 这样比较特别的灵魂，投胎在动物躯体里可以记得前世的情形，还是每个做过奉献服务的人都会记得前世的情形呢？Is it the only special souls like Bharat Maharaj can remember his past life when he's in the body of animal, or each one who has done devotional service can remember his past conditions?
It's not very common. Bharat Maharaj was a special soul.Who was already very advanced in devotional service, but somehow he fell down.
这种情况不是很普遍的。Bharat Maharaj 是特殊的灵魂，他已经非常十分进步了。他从事了奉献服务，但是后来他堕落了。
So Krishna arranged that he get this dear body.To help him be more serious in the future.
Krishna 就安排他有了鹿的这样的躯体，从而能够在为来世能够对灵修更加的认真。
Yeah. 下一个问题。
下一个问题是 Radha 的问题。顶拜 Gurudev， 请问怎么理解圣人进入动物躯体是 Krishna 的仁慈，而不是他的业报呢？如果我们普通人这一副仪式依附动物，下辈子我们变成动物也会记起上一世吗？我们的下下一世也会变成人继续灵修吗
？Yeah, well.Bharat Maharaj, we said, it was a special case. Usually, a devotee is not put into an animal body.
Bharat Maharaj 这种情况是特殊情况。通常而言，奉献者不会被置于一个动物的躯体当中。
But it was a special case to teach him a lesson to be more careful.When he does his devotional service.
这是给他一个教训，让他做奉献服的时候要更加小心。
But ordinary devotees like us, if we get put in the animal body, we won't remember a previous life.
像我们这样的普通奉献者，倘若得到动物的躯体。不会记得前世。
And it may take a long time before we come back to the human body.
而且再次得到人类躯体之前，可能要经历很长的时间。
And when we do come back to the human body, we won't get the body in a good devotee family or a Brahmin family.
当我们再次回到人体生命当中。不会是一个奉献者的家庭，或者是 Brahmana 的家庭。
But it depends how much devotional service we've actually done.
但这也取决于我们曾经做过多少奉献服务。
Have you been serious when you were doing the devotional service? Were you really chanting properly?
从事奉献服务的时候，是不是非常的认真呢？是不是正确的念诵了呢
？Have you been cooking eggs? Sometimes devotees, even initiated devotees, sometimes they cook eggs.
有的启迪，有的奉献者启迪之后还做鸡蛋。
Sometimes they drink coffee or tea.
有时候他们喝咖啡茶。
And often they don't chant.
他们常常不念诵。
But they claim, I'm a devotee.
但还自称我是奉献者。
So Krishna says, as you surrender to me, I reward you accordingly.
Krishna 说了，根据一个人对我皈依的程度，我予以相应的回报。
So if we surrender to Krishna really, Krishna will help us come back to him.
如果我们真心实意地臣服 Krishna,Krishna 就会帮助我们回到他那里。
But don't try to cheat Krishna.
但是不要试图欺骗 Krishna.
Because Krishna is a better cheat than us.
因为 Krishna 是比我们更好的，更精湛的一个骗子。
还有问题吗？
还有一个 Govinda Nandini 的问题，顶拜 Guru， 怎么才能让自己在 Krishna 之间中一直不保持不堕落呢？
Well, you have to be very serious about your sadhana.
你要对你的 sadhana 非常的认真。
You have to really want to be Krishna conscious.
你要真正的希望有 Krishna 知觉。
We cannot just say, oh, I have a child, I can't do all these things, I can't chant 16 rounds, I have my child to look after.
你不能说，我有孩子，我不能做这些，我不能念十六圈，我还得照顾我的孩子。
You have to do proper sadhana. You have to chant. You have to worship Krishna. You have to offer prasadam.
你需要做正确的 sadhana， 念诵、崇拜、做 prasadam。
You have to follow the process. You know what the process is. You just have to follow it.
你还要遵守这个程序方法。你知道方法，你必须得按照这个方法去做。
下一个问题。
下一个问题来自 Sati Dasi。当我们处在居士进阶。履行职责，服务父母、儿女、孙子，不依附，相信 Krishna 会很好照顾他们，但外在表现就是对家人没有情感。如果想让他们觉得对他们有爱，就会被这些职责束缚。请问 Gurudev， 怎么能既不依附，又让家人感到满意呢？
快乐。亲爱的，那 Guruman Manaji， 你读的有一个是错误的，就是他说的是不依附，相信 Krishna 会很好的照顾他们。你刚才读的那个正好会是相反的意思。
对，是，就是不依附这个职责，相信 Krishna 会照顾他们，是吗？
对，是这样的意思。
Yes, it's difficult. We know.
是的，这很难。我们知道有难度。
You have to pray to Krishna, give you the intelligence how to do everything.
你要向 Krishna 祈祷，给您做事做好一切事情的智慧。
Your children grow up. They soon grow up and they're big. They're adults. They take care of themselves. You don't need to worry about them.
您的孩子长大成人之后，可以自己照顾自己，不需要担别人来担心了。
You spend some time to take care of your elderly parents. Okay, for some time, not forever.
你 花一部分时间拿来照顾自己的长辈，但是这不是永远，不需要永远的。
So, you have to have a balance between your duties in the material world and your Krishna consciousness.
您需要在物质的植物和您的 Krishna 知觉二者之间平衡。
You have to make sure you get some time to chant. You get some time to your own self for your private life.
您要给自己念诵留时间，还要给自己的私生活留时间。
So this is the challenge. Well, everybody has this challenge. Everyone, you know, other people also, not only in China, everywhere.People also, they have jobs, they have to keep their jobs, they're working in the job. There's always obstacles.
这些都是挑战。别人也有他们自个的挑战，不仅是在中国，在世界的其他地方，他们有工作，还要维持他们工作，他们也有自己的障碍。
But Krishna can remove all the obstacles if we surrender to Him. Krishna can help us to get rid of all these.
Krishna 能够帮助我们去除这些障碍，如果我们臣服 Krishna.
Everybody has these obstacles, everyone.Not only you, we're always thinking, oh, my situation. But everybody has obstacles, everyone has problems. This is part of the life. We want to become Krishna conscious, we have to overcome these obstacles.
人人都要面临自己的障碍，不仅是您有障会遇到，每一个人都有各自的情况。有面临各自的问题，在生活当中都会面临着这些，所以要成为 Krishna 这些就要克服这些障碍。
下一个问题，
下一个问题是来自于 ICY。顶拜孤队，请问唱诵是最吉祥、最完美了，为什么还有这么多的规范、这么多服务，都不知道该哪些该放下，哪些该做了，时间没有，不够用啊。Although chanting is most auspicious and most perfect method.Why are there so many rules and regulations, so many kind variety of service? I don't know what service should I do and what should I give up? Because the time is not enough.
Well, you have to do 16 rounds minimum every day.
您每天应该至少念16圈。
That's very important. You can't avoid that.
这是非常。 常重要的，这是不能少的。
Then you have to follow four principles. You can't change that.
您要遵守四项原则，这是不能改变的。
We have to do what's necessary. People ask us to do some service. If they ask us to help do something, we help them. We try to help them.
我们需要做必须做的必要的事情。有人需要他们做服务，需要我们帮助他们，我们可以帮助他们。
下一个问题。
下一个问题是狗温的南丁尼的问题。丁拜姑的灵安族，我们做奉爱服务是质量重要还是数量更重要？
Both are important.
都重要。
Quality and quantity. You want to have both quality and quantity.But we say 重质不重量啊。Sometimes people say 重质不重量。We give importance to quality, not quantity.
有时候人们就重视质而不重视量。
We talk about devotees like that. Some people say,there's not many devotees in Krishna consciousness, there's so many people in the other things. You know, the Buddhas and other places, there's so many people. So then we would say, 重质不重量, you know? you know, we think we're so much better, although we're not many people.But actually, both is important. We want quality and quantity.
有时候，我们就说重质不重量。我们 Krishna 就觉得，虽然人少，但是不像佛教有那么多的人，但实际上呢，都重要，质也重要，量也重要。
So we need to make more devotees.We need to,
我们需要创造大量的奉献者。
And they should be quality devotees.
而且是有质量的奉献者。
Not just imitation, not just pretending.
不是模仿的奉献者，不是假装的奉献者。
下一个问题。
下一个是 A， 四业苦行一定要遵守吗？遵守不遵守，结果又会如何？
Prabhupada has given us a very simple basis for following the 4 months of austerity. Very simple program. First month, we don't eat the green leafy vegetable.
帕帕德给了我们遵守四月苦行的最基本的方法。第一个月是不食绿叶蔬菜。
Right. Second month, no yogurt.
第二个月是不吃酸奶。
Third month, no milk.
第三个月是不吃牛奶，不喝牛奶。
On the fourth month.No high protein foods like soya.
第四个月不吃高蛋白的食物，比如说黄豆。
So this is a very minimum standard of Chaturmasya. But we're supposed to follow, everyone. It's for our purification. How you went, Tima? We don't just eat vegetarian food. We have to eat food offered to Krishna, prasadam. What was the other things? Chant 16 rounds, follow four principles.
And listen lecture on the internet.
Well, there's
is that enough?
No, not enough.
不够.
Very minimum. That's very minimum standard, very low standard of devotion.
这是最低的标准。
You should do more. You should always think how I can do more. Don't think what's the least I can do. If you're thinking what's the minimum I can do, that's very bad mood, very bad attitude. You should think, how can I do more?
Yogadharma Devadasi. 顶拜姑爹请教姑乳。 四月苦行戒食绿叶蔬菜, 我家卡布说, 那个红叶子蔬菜, 在不在戒食之列呢?
红叶蔬菜可以吃。
红叶蔬菜可以吃。
绿叶蔬菜不吃。 红叶没问题。
哦，红叶没问题。二宝，这，我看见了，哈瑞邦萨，漏掉了一个，上面的是哈瑞邦萨大的问题，他布的问题。前几天拜访了海口的一对奉献者年轻居士，他们有孩子，家居很简单，每天。 很好的崇拜，很喜乐生活，感觉就是居士的榜样。是不是远离亲人关系和奉献者生活在一起，过简单的工作更有利于灵性进步呢？
Funny.
They went to Haikou.
And they had a nice,
Island.
Yeah, and you saw the ideal householder family, and yeah, and they had a baby, and
yes.
Then what?
The question is that, is it favorable for spiritual advancement if live far from relatives and live with devotees?
Yes.
And live a simple life.
Very favorable.
是的，很非常有利。
Because relatives are not devotees, so they will just hinder your spiritual life. But you have to be able to maintain yourself without the help of the relatives. Okay. Any questions? Any more? How you went, Ma? No. No. Okay. 今天到这儿，可以吗？ Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Jai.
Guru Mani ki. Radha Priya ki.
Jai.
Sati ki. God Bhakti Vrinda ki.
Jai.
God Premanandi. Haribo.
Haribo.